Yeah, hey, my name is Dominic Lipp. I'm from Resultat, and I'm going to show you how to do a 4G upgrade on the decoder.
So you need to make sure that the decoder is updated to the correct firmware and to the newest one. After that, turn the decoder off and make sure to unplug the power cable, as we're going to expose the inner leads, which are powered if you have it plugged in. After that, there's 6 screws all around the decoder that you have to unscrew. I took the liberty of already taking 4 of them out for this video so that we don't have to wait so long. Unscrew these, set them to the side, we'll need them later. After that, you can open the decoder. To do that, you can lift at the GPS housing. Sometimes it is stuck a bit, then you can pull it up, and once you can take it out, you flip it upwards to the back. This exposes the insides. So once we have it propped up on the lid to the back, we have to unplug 2 cables. First of all, it's the Ethernet cable that connects the mainboard to the internal reader. We can just set that down there. And the second is the power leads that come from the battery. To get rid of these cables, we just undo this twist tie, pull them out carefully. The ground wire stays inside, the rest we can lay down into the decoder. Now, we can take the whole front panel and just set it down so that we have a nice workbench to work on. So, once we are inside here, we can see the 3G module, which we're going to be replacing with the 4G module. So, first of all, you can carefully unplug the main connector connecting the 3G module to the mainboard. This is kind of fiddly, and you should be careful with the connector. Now we have that undone. The next thing we have to unplug is the auxiliary antenna. If you're coming from a 2G module, you will not have this installed and you will need to install it separately. Please refer to the 3G guide to see how that's done. To unplug it, we just carefully pull this connector away from the PCB. This is how it comes undone. After that, we have 2 Phillips head screws again. Using our screwdriver, we just unscrew these, being careful not to damage anything in the process. One screw. Second screw. That's it. The 3G module is loose now, and we can just carefully lift it up. It's only held in place by the SIM card slot over here. This is what you'll be getting if you order the 4G upgrade to do yourself. The auxiliary antenna, which is most likely already installed in your system. 2 cables, you will only be needing 1 of these, and the 4G module itself. So now, let's go to installing the 4G module. So for my decoder, I have an older mainboard version, which means that I can only be using the 5-pin connector right here. On newer mainboards, like this one right here, we have a 6-pin connector. It also says right here that it's 6X for the GSM. So we will have to choose the wire accordingly. So for me, it's this one as it only has 5 leads. First of all, we will be installing the 5-pin cable into the 4G board for me. The 5-pin cable goes into the 6-pin connector facing the left side. There's a small arrow marking it on the PCB under the connector. So the 5-pin cable has to be plugged in all the way to this side. So make sure the metal parts of the connector are facing down and just carefully slide it in. This should not take much force as these connectors are delicate. After you've done this, you can take the cable and route it through this slot to the back of the module, just like I did here. Now it comes out the backside neatly, and we can start installing it into our decoder. So to do this, we need to make sure that our antenna cable goes through the slot in the bottom, and then we can slide it in with the SIM card slot into the slot in the front panel. After this, we can screw in the module. Be sure to don't over tighten these screws. They do not need much force to hold the module solidly in place. Second screw goes in. Sometimes they need some realigning. Now that we have it in place, we can plug in the antenna. I like to do it this way around. Other people's plug in the antenna cable first. This is up to you what you like more. And then after that, we have to plug in the connector to the main board. Again, not using much force. That was it. We changed our 3G module with a 4G module. Now it's just back to putting the decoder back together. To close the decoder back up, we just lift it back up. Make sure it's the right way around. So this is the front panel. It goes in like this. So we prop it up on the back again like we did when opening it. Now we need to plug in the reader again. And we need to plug in the main power lead. Make sure that this little hook aligns with the tab on the connector. Just plug it in. That's it. Put the cables back into the twist tie so they don't get pinched anywhere when you're closing the system. Be careful where the cables go. Also, check the Ethernet cable that it's not between the main board and the reader. After that, just press the front panel back into place. Mine takes a bit of effort, others go easier. This is just because over time the case can deform slightly. We're only talking about a few millimeters, but when taking it apart and putting it together, you do feel it. After that, we have 6 screws to put in. I'm gonna only do 2 today, and we're done. After that, you can test your system, make sure it gets a solid connection with over the 4G network, and happy racing.